Are you tired and fed up with the leveling process? Can't figure out the optimal tree for DPS and survivability? Fear not! Introducing the Wonder Punch package, yours to keep and blast your way through the leveling process for a one-time payment of $94.99. Shipping not included. Welcome, it's your friendly neighborhood Badger here, and I'm back with a quick and concise guide to leveling literally any character ever with the new One With Nothing cluster jewel. It doesn't matter if you're going to play a spellcaster, a mace wielder, or a jewel wielding witch, this jewel plus a fairly affordable set of items can carry you through the entire leveling process for under an exalted orb cost. Before we start, there are two things to note. You will need to respec a few points once reaching endgame, so be prepared to use a few regret orbs, but not too many should be needed. Also, these prices were taken at the time of recording during Delirium League, and I have no idea whether they will rise or fall in price, so be wary of that. Below in the description, there is a very basic tree with the items we will talk about soon for each of the 7 starting classes, as well as a pathing to an outer jewel socket. This leveling technique can be implemented as quick as you can get to an outer socket, but doesn't fully come online until level 24, with another big upgrade at level 30. But enough of that, let's talk about the items, shall we? First, we must talk about the Bell of the Ball, the One With Nothing unique cluster jewel. This jewel gives you massive bonuses while unencumbered, which means no weapons or gloves equipped, such as 60% more attack speed and 14 to 20 physical damage per 10 dexterity. The latter line is what this leveling process focuses on with pretty much all of our gear, as we will be stacking crazy amounts of dexterity for insane damage. This jewel, at the time of recording, can be picked up for a measly 40 chaos. Next, in no particular order, we will talk about the gear. Firstly, you will want to pick up a 6-linked Fox Shade, which are extremely cheap on the market at 10 chaos. This gives a good amount of dexterity and some movement speed for fast movement during leveling. However, we must keep in mind that colouring this chest piece for the colours we need may be difficult. For our clearing setup in this chest piece, we need 4 off colours, being 3 red and 1 blue. This can be tried using the 1 red and 1 blue craft on the crafting bench, but if you don't want to try your luck, feel free to just use a tabula rasa. It will do the job for the same cost and just a little less damage and survivability. Our main skill while leveling goes in this chest piece, which honestly can be any unarmed skill you prefer, but I prefer to use Consecrated Path. It has great movement with its blink aspect and deals great damage. Consecrated Path is linked with faster attacks, physical to lightning, elemental damage with attacks, melee physical damage, and onslaught. This setup will make you feel like a true ninja, blasting through all the acts like an absolute boss. If you feel like it, you can switch to Cyclone at level 28 for more damage but less survivability and movement. Next, we will talk about the rings and amulet. For both rings, you want to be using Le Hoop of All rings. These rings honestly have everything we want. Good attributes, great resistances, and good generic damage. Try to purchase rings with a higher roll of attributes because every point counts. These rings are an easy 1 to 2 chaos each. The amulet we use is Astramentis. At a very easy 40 chaos for such a good amulet, it gives a crazy amount of attributes, and you can even anoint it with a large dexterity node on the tree for more, or use attribute catalyst to buff it even further. Next, the helmet. Gold rim. Do I have to say any more? Amazing resistances for leveling. Done. Boots, you have a few options. You can start with Victario's Flight for a small amount of dexterity and some good movement speed, or you can also use 7 League Steps, which have a crazy 50% movement speed. Keep in mind that 7 League Steps are not necessary and are a little pricey at around about 1 Exalt. At level 30, you can switch to Lionized Paws, and for 10 Chaos, these give a massive boost to dexterity, up to 60. And that's it, those items will carry you through everything. You might feel a little squishy, so if you don't like the occasional death, you may want to spec into some good life nodes along the way, or exchange your boots for some higher life boots. The only other skill gems you really want to obtain will be Dash and Second Wind linked for good movement, as well as an Ancestral Protector for even more damage against bosses. You can then use a Hatred Aura or Herald of Ash for even more damage. However, as stated before, this leveling process doesn't really come online until level 24. Quickly, I will explain a very basic leveling process for each different class. Marauder, Duelist, and Raider can easily be leveled with Frostblades linked to Onslaught and Ancestral Call, with Double Strike linked to Maim and Chance to Bleed, and just picking up white weapons to dual wield along the way. This will carry you easily to level 24. Shadow, Witch, and Templar can be leveled extremely easily with Freezing Pulse, linked to Arcane Surge and Added Lightning, with a single target of Stormblast Mine linked with Trap and Mine damage and Added Lightning damage. Scion, you can honestly level either way. I prefer the Frostblades myself. Again, the trees below in the description are for every class, but to be honest, you just have to path directly to an outer jewel socket and you're good. If anyone has any other questions or ideas about this process, chuck them in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching, everyone. As always, if you liked this content, hit that subscribe button down below if you haven't already, and click that little bell just for the notifications so you can get great info whenever it comes out from me. Thank you so much, guys, and until next time, Badger out.